And we just have to figure out what Perks wants to play into Zoe. There you go.
Yeah, Vulcan having some fun, but it is going to be Ryze into Zoe there. RJS kind of as expected, taking that pick. I think it's Dragon. The Viper stole the Raptors. He's going to go ahead and take the Drake. And Broxah in the area, but not around to steal it. No smite, but no problem there for Blava. Have covered.
Turret plate picked up here for Sven, and they slowly continue to increase these leads.
Ooh, Turtle is eating a lot of damage.
One
there,
feather?
Suspects. There is a jungler in the area, but no ulti there for Vulcan. That looks like a kill to me. Indeed, it is. It's first blood is Sven.
Getting full value out of the Rift Herald, two plates by hand, then the next two with the Rift Herald activation. It was some good money to help them try and catch up
on the Mythic, but still up in CS, feeling good as Fudge is continuing to try and dodge Aatrox Qs. It's not been a particularly fun job, but it is a full-time one here as Fudge gets the ulti down because there's two more members of Cloud9 running in hot. There's the Chilling Smite down. Finn, Worldender again to get out, but Viper's going to follow there with the Rek'Sai ulti. The knockup is not going to fall, but Fudge will find the stun. And now Brox are going to get kicked away by Vulcan as he
Make the direction the other way. He's got plenty of distance. RJS now.
Perks going in. Now no ignite there for Perks, but I don't think it matters. I think Perks can line this up. There's the guy's a W. Good flash from RJS, though. Gets himself out. It's 9. CLG actually counter pushing very nicely thanks to that poke between Zoe and Zaya. And they should be able to get this tower.
Very strong in the group. Remember again, have a lot of tools to choose.
Oh, Blabber's in there, the Prowler's Claws popped, and that's going to be a 1v1 kill under the tower. He goes with the ulti, and Rek'Sai collects it, and now Blabber's got to figure out a way to get out here. He's going to be put to sleep very soon, going to get spun on an Eept, and that's Brox with a very nice trade.
All right. They have plenty of tools to look for picks with. Your Swirl Seed from Lilia and your Bubbles. There we go, though.
Smoothie finds a lineup, gets two there with the Magnet Storm. Blabber just dead. That's going to be the Dragon, but it could be more for Cloud9. CLG going to go golden there for Broxah as the junglers may die on both sides. But Perk's now still going to have to cut it out, but he dies to the AD. That's what it was. As Vulcan now going to bounce out there. As Sven going to move in onto Turtle. Vulcan looking low. Sven's going to finish him off, and CLG looking good. Turtle needs to live. Will not be able to do so as Fudge finishes him off with a Q. And now Finn still chasing onto Sven. Sven can't really run anywhere, and definitely Gragas can't run anywhere. Sven is going to get dunked, and Fudge going to be killed as well. CLG start up to play, and they're going to finish it with an ace. Indeed, it will be as Finn nails that triple kill.
Goes for the initiation on CLG's terms, and we see what a Rek'Sai does without flash in team fights here. Easily now or outnumbered situations where you can jump on them, kill them in the full burst. Here we go. Might get one here.
TP in as well. Smoothie already looking low. Blabber just assassinates Rell.
Vengeance.
And the health bar disappears. Here comes Fudge. Now going to TP up and use the topside pressure instead. Turtle no ulti. It's back up in a couple seconds, but it's got no flash. Fudge bounces him back with the Gale Force. Maybe going to keep Perks alive. The root onto Perks. He's going to be put to sleep as well, but Turtle is going to die. It's just a matter of who gets the kill. The Featherstone's back up, but it's not enough to save him. And now Finn fighting on the other side as RJS finds a great bubble there on the Finn, but now the bounce back for Sven as he killer instincts through the Aatrox. Blabber puts the ulti down onto Finn as he's going to have to flash over the wall to safety. And C9 answer back with a team fight win of their own.
Yeah, just like that, they're going to get some picks on top side and start up the Baron. The rewards for this one are going to be quite a bit bigger, Pastry Time. Zoe still poking around with Bubbles, though.
Oh, Perks, what a good sidestep, though. Gets the root as well. Needs to follow up with a bit of extra perk to keep Zoe away from the pit. RJS, though, still peppering the Paddle Stars in, but Cloud9, they're dedicated to finishing this Baron.
They're here.
Smoothie back, though, but he's got no ulti. That's going to be a knockback there for Vulcan. Fudge also getting low. The Baron is going to go over. Somebody needs to hit it. Indeed, it is Sven that collects it. And now Cloud9, it's time to retreat. Over the wall goes Blabber, over the wall goes Fudge, and everyone's safe as they escape with the Infernal Rift, but there's a lot of extra space for Alistar to go recon some info. That's topside.
No, they're going to take you out, but with the stopwatch, if you put extra points in the E early on, it can buy you enough time to just take a tunnel back out. It doesn't have to be a one-way trip here, so Cloud9 at a very big power spike right now, slowly using the Baron buff. To continue to whittle down on these secondary towers. They already locked up the top outer one. Mid-secondary goes down as well. Cloud9 already positioning on the Dragon. Plenty of wards here, and Blabber goes.
Blabber already in. Does maybe have the ulti. No, not going to commit it just yet. Vulcan, though, back in. That was the bait and switch they wanted as Fudge looks for the kill, and Blabber finds the ulti kill. Now Broxah going to go golden, but he's got one pixel of health left. As Sven's going to take out Smoothie. Perks is going to take out Broxah, and Cloud9 fainted for the Dragon and took three kills instead. As now Perks is flashing in. Sven is killer instincting over. That's a double kill for the Kai'Sa, and maybe make it the ace as Finn is the only one for CLG left alive as Fudge, ever persistent, said, "You remember me in top lane? That wasn't very nice. So I'm going to have my buddy Perks come up here and try and take you up." Be careful though, Fudge, because that tower is awfully strong. but Perk's going to take the next shot. C9 going to break through mid, and they'll get the in-heal plus 4 kills to boot.
Oh, Pastry, that 1-2 punch from Blabber and Vulcan was so beautiful to watch. Blabber goes in, Psy ult is in, and CLG just collapse at the decisive engage from Cloud9. This is something C9 have done so well, regardless of rosters. Here we go, though. Perk's now going to be the victim.
1v3, 1v4, can he get... Nope, okay, never mind. Shut down by Finn very swiftly. The loving arms of Perks as Vulcan has found himself in a very cheeky spot. Oh, he gets found out, though. RJS checking that brush. And now CLG may be looking for the Baron, but Vulcan's actually going to start the fight up already. He's stunned up RJS. Fudge with the big flank TP ward. And there's RJS. He's going to have to flash out of there. And now Zvengen running with the Killer Instinct, but the Stasis is going to keep this Zoe alive. But Cloud9 now final in. Zvengen going to be on a killing freeze. He takes down Smoothie. And it looks like absolute carnage here as Cloud9 are going to run over the rest of CLG. But Finn actually has found a way back through. He's going to get the knock up onto Perks. It's Turtle also fighting back at CLG in a 2v2. It's a triple kill for Turtle. It's a quadra kill for Turtle. And CLG have turned it back around as Finn is going to send up the Penta for his new teammate as Turtle grabs the Penta kill.
Oh my goodness! And Turtle's ultimate never was blown. Nobody initiated on him this time around. That was such a big difference to the previous team fight. And then him and Finn pick up the Baron ride, kill, raising up his teammates as well. CLG really starting to come into their own here over the season where they've really had to deal with so many roster swaps. And yet, Brox's first day on the job, already looking good.
Yeah, he put a great amount of time there with his ulti despite dying when it stays. His Perks is busy split pushing because Cloud9 have maybe thought about the 5v5 and how it's not so fun, especially with CLG having Baron. So they will lose that top inhibitor tower. Perks can maybe revisit, but again, took cleanse for this matchup. Doesn't have TP, just has his ulti. CLG gonna run in and get
They are split pushing. Of course it's kind of comical, but they are split pushing bottom side. You see Perks down there working away at this tower. Does get a secondary one for himself, but CLG will be very happy to pick up this inhib.
Are they trying to race here? Perks can get a lot of damage done. There's actually only 3 towers left for CLG, unless I'm missing one, I might be. But Perks are going to take that one out. Now he's opened up the inhibitors. They're all exposed. Perks is like kind of making a bid towards the Nexus here.
Ryze actually does so much a lot of damage. Minion waves, because they're the ones looking for all these flank angles. But here goes CLG, grouped up as 5, running them down.
That TP is very ambitious from Finn, but it maybe is the flank they wanted. He's taking a little bit too much damage, but onto Blabber he goes. Now Blabber going to have to run away. The GA does pop as Fudge ultis already to try and kick out the rest of CLG, but they're continuing that fight. Smoothie again finds 2 with the Magnet Storm, and now Finn and Brox are trying to fight for their life as Vulcan's tanking it up. But Turtle, he finds the kill on the Perks. That's what CLG wanted. They try and rush down one of C9's carriers, and they get it, but now Sven is still alive and he's shooting everybody. As Smoothie's got only a couple points of health left, but Finn does block the incoming W. So CLG, they win the fight and they're pushing through mid. Cloud9 have to respond very quickly.
Oh, RJS trying to stop the backs as well. They've got the minion wave to work with. Blabber's here to try and answer.
All right, Vulcan again can also kick a carry away from the tower, but one tower is going to fall. RJS late to the party, but Sven even later must have missed his invite in the mail because Cloud9 needs to get these minions out very, very quickly. Fudge is going in on the Turtle. They need to get the damage down, but it's not quite enough. There's the Resurrect as the Kai'Sa W does connect, but Cloud9 needs to commit. Oh, Fudge, he missed timed it, but it doesn't matter. Sven, he finds the shutdown. Now Finn's going to dive back in. He needs to kill this guy, but Sven's out of there. He KIs onto RJS, and now he's fighting 1v2. He gets a double. He's going to get 3. He's going to maybe get 4. Is it his Penta? No, it's not. It's Finn who's going to keep the game alive for CLG, but 2v2 with no help on Broxa. It's support and jungle, both top lane and jungle, and nobody's really got much left as Blabber looking awfully menacing, but I don't know he can really do much as both...
Sven, 4 combos in, they GA, even though Fudge mistimes the revival on the GA, Finn is creating a lot of space here, and Sven is forced to ult in to the rest.
Actually, Perks has started solo again. In fact, it's solo already. Broxa can maybe get in, but no, he will be kept out. And Cloud9 are going to play for both objectives and secure them. Well, Finn is the other big player for CLG as far as gold goes, so we'll see what happens. But this is a very tricky fight to navigate. With Baron buff, supers are streaming in everywhere. Already have bot in hip. Now going to take mid in hip. Perks just explodes for Smoothie, and he's just going to be left for dead. Will be killed. Pops the Magnet Storm, but it doesn't matter. Attracting nothing but the fountain there as Cloud9 5v4 are going to move in to finish off this Nexus. Perks, he's getting a little low, but low is not good enough. as CLG now still fighting as Broxy getting low. Blabber diving in. He wants turtle. That's all he's got on his mind is Fudge. He's going to dive in there as well. Long Spine's winning. Takes out Broxy with the Gale Force as Fudge dives in onto turtle and makes sure the kill happens. And that is all they need with the Nexus open to take the game. It's going to be an ace at the end of it all as Finn, I take it back, is still going to live. But Blabber going to try and buy time for that to happen. Instead, it is Cloud9 finishing off the Nexus just under 40 minutes.